What's up, Creed? Coach Andrew, Coach Mandy coming at you with your Friday workout, one day away from July 4th. Hope you got some plans to enjoy some fireworks tomorrow. If not, you can always do this workout again on Saturday if you'd like to. But we got our warm-up, we got a two-part workout, and we got a finisher at the end for you today. So let's go ahead and jump into it. We got our workout here. Part A is an EMOM by 9 minutes, so if you have a timer, go ahead, set that up for 9 minutes. Run every minute on the minute. We have three moves here. All of them are for 45 seconds with a 15-second rest. Our first move, we got a dumbbell sumo deadlift, all right? So our feet are outside our shoulder width, all right? So we're kind of uncomfortable with that position, like a sumo wrestler, way outside our shoulders. We're driving those hips back, kind of getting those knees about even with our hips here, letting that chest fall forward, and we're tapping that dumbbell to the ground all while keeping our shoulders pinned back, all right? Movement two, we have tuck ups. So we're on the ground in our hollow hold position, and we're bringing that upper body and those knees together, kind of like a mini V up, all right? Kind of get those knees and chest to come together. Good control on the way up and on the way back down. Going for 45 seconds, so try to pace these out, all right? Those will start to burn. Movement three, we have our wall sit. So if you have a wall, go ahead, find a spot there. We're going 90 degrees with those feet, from our feet to our shins to our thighs, all right? Sharp 90 degree angles. Don't get too low, too high. We want to get perfect sharp angles in those knees. If we don't have a wall to sit upon, then we can always do an active squat hold just out there in the air, try to hold 90 degrees. It will be a little bit harder, but I haven't killed anyone. Anyways, part B, got an E2 mom, all right? So now every 2 minutes on the minute for 10 minutes. I mean, we have five rounds here with three movements. Again, we have five tuck jumps, which our tuck jumps will be right here. We're gonna try and jump nice and high, get those arms come back. When we jump up, try to bring those knees nice and high. So we're not just jumping in the air, we're also bringing those knees up at the top of our jump. We have five of those after our five tuck jumps. Then we have 10 and 10 on our dumbbell hang power clean. So 10 on the right side and 10 on the left side. But we're doing hang power clean today. So we're coming to the top of that knee, not past our knee, just the top of the knee. And we're extending through our hips, squeezing those glutes, getting a nice little hop at the top. And we're gonna let that dumbbell travel all the way up our body with a nice high elbow, dropping under and then catching that front rack position, all right? Once we get 10 and 10, then we go into 40 double unders or 120 single unders today. All right, and if you don't have a jump rope, obviously you can do ghost rope here, just regular kind of imitating that we have a jump rope in our hands, but that's 40 double unders or 120 single unders. We'll rotate through those five rounds for a total of 10 minutes, all right? We have 2 minutes to complete one set of those, all right? So it's gonna be a nice push pace there. The time you have left over in both of these EMOMs is your rest time, all right? When we get to our finisher, we'll demo that, be a little core burner here, but we'll go ahead and jump into our warm up today. So all we need is a dumbbell, and that's it, all right? So go ahead, grab a dumbbell, 15, 20 pounds maybe. We're gonna start with a minute of cardio choice, and then we're gonna go into an AMRAP by 4 minutes. We have 10 single arm Russian dumbbell swings. We have that dumbbell, going swinging with that dumbbell, single arm, right hand, and then we're going into 5 and 5 single dumbbell deadlifts. So 5 deadlifts in the right hand, 5 deadlifts in the left hand, and then we're switching to the left hand again, single arm dumbbell swings with that left hand. So we're getting both sides there. And then 5 bodyweight squats without the dumbbell. All right? Good to go?
Good to go.
Good to go. We got 5 minutes on our timer on our end. If you'd like to set up 5 minutes on your clock, feel free to, or move along with us. And we're rolling in 10.
Start with a minute of cardio.
3, 2, 1. Here we go. Just a friendly reminder, go ahead and turn on some music. You got it, pause the video, get it bumping. You should know why we can't have music on these by now. YouTube is a big meanie.
Exactly why.
There's a big, they don't want us to have fun.
You know, they might hear you say that.
Probably.
Neither do you.
They would, it's YouTube, man. They're so mean.
So mean. 30 seconds.
Drive those hips back to hip hinge. We're We're not squatting down with this weight. Don't let that dumbbell travel past our knees. Keep it nice and close to our hips, right under our hips there. We got 5 and 5 on our single dumbbell deadlifts. Just tapping that dumbbell between our shoelaces. These wall sits are gonna be tough. I can already feel it. My legs don't want to be here today. There we go. Got about 90 more seconds here. Might squeeze in one more round. Last 20 seconds, we'll finish off here with these 5 bodyweight squats. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, so part A, Iman by 9 minutes. Remember, we should need a dumbbell for these. 45 seconds of our dumbbell sumo deadlifts. We got a wide stance today, so even wider than what you did in the warm-up. And then we have 45 seconds of tuck-ups and 45 seconds of a wall sit or an active squat hold, all right? 3 rounds of these 3, 3 sets of these 3. Be sure to take your tempo a little bit slower today. Don't try to speed through these 45 seconds. Don't burn yourself out in the first round. We're gonna last all 45 seconds here. It's gonna be tough with the tuck-ups and maybe for the wall sit, but I definitely think sumo deadlifts.
Yeah.
All 45 seconds. We'll see how it feels there.
Yeah. You get a 15 second transition time. Look how sweet we're being.
Look at that, 15 seconds. All 15.
You don't always get that.
Exactly. We usually just match up sometimes.
Yeah.
All right. So we got 1 minute on the clock for 9 rounds here. Raise our Tabata timer. And if you're ready, go ahead and roll along with us. If you're not, pause the video. Grab your water if you need it, get your dumbbell, get everything set up, and you'll go ahead and roll with us in 10. Start with those dumbbell sumo deadlifts here. those feet are angled outward at a 45 degree angle and those knees are tracking over our toes. Don't let them collapse in or go too far outside of them. We want our knees to go directly over our toes. Tuck ups next. Whew. These are going to be fun first round. See how they feel.
Good old tuck ups. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That dumbbell is tapping in between our feet, not out front or behind, but directly straight down and straight back up. two, one. Here we go. We got one more time through with these three, and we'll call it a day for part A.
Okay, kind of right.
Two, one. Emphasize a squeeze at the top with your glutes. If you got a full hip extension, standing real tall. We got 10 more. Three, two, and one. Done with the sumo deadlifts for today. Now we're going into our tuck ups for one last time. Three, two, one. Really a little tight there, a little tight. You need to work that out. Let's get a good stretch on. Here we go. Last set of wall sits. Three, two, and we're down. Gonna make sure we're nice and even. Thighs should be a tabletop position. We're not slanted down. Have them face the angle up on a good 90-degree angle here. So, imitate just like you have it. All right, part two, we got 10 minutes on the clock. It's an E2MOM, all right? So every 2 minutes on the minute, we'll have 120 seconds to complete these three reps, these three movements. First movement is our five tuck jumps, so five reps there, and then 10 and 10 on our hang power cleans, and then we have 40 double unders or 120 single unders to finish with, all right? So try to bust through these as quick as we can so we get a little rest time before that 2 minute mark, all right?
And y'all, if you have ankle or knee problems like me, then you can do up downs instead of tuck jumps. But try those tuck jumps if you know it's not gonna hurt anything. So try to get as high as Andrew does. It's a challenge.
Definitely, try to. Probably gonna start getting real low towards the end of this EMOM. Legs are gonna go out from under me. All right, so we have our timer set up, 2 minutes for five rounds, total of 10 minutes of work here. All right, so remember, the quicker we work, the longer rest we have. So try to burn through these reps as quick as we can. Real big push, earn your rest time today, all right?
All right.
Remember, if we don't get through all our reps, as soon as that timer hits 2 minutes, we're restarting at the top with those tug jumps. Sound good?
Let's do it, y'all.
Let's roll in 10.
2 minutes of work at a time. Two, one, go.
Did 12 on that arm, not a lot. Oh, I know it's got to even out on the other side. It's 12 and 12, guys. We got a hold of the minute here. We have a little better round this time. I packed into that 2 minutes.
Okay, we're getting faster now.
We're getting faster though. Get familiar with the movements. Get familiar with the movements. Get more efficient. Get more quick.
Three in. Two go.
Two more to go. That's 4 more minutes here. We got 5 seconds.
3, 2, 1.
Losing it. I lost my mental. So we got 5 sets of 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off. So sort of like an EMOM here, but we're going with Tabata timer. All right, we're going with a long plank. All right, so we're not a regular plank, we just want a high plank position. But once we get in a high plank position, we can either walk our feet back or walk our hands forward to get in that long plank. All right, see how our hands are out in front of our shoulders now? It's a little bit harder to keep that active hold. So don't go out so far to where you start to make a U. We don't want our hips to drop to the ground here. Don't want all that pressure to go to our low back. Gotta focus on tilting that pelvis under and keeping that core tight, ribs locked down, all right? So if it gets too hard, if our hands are all the way out here, we're on the ground, bring those hands under just a little bit more, not all the way under our shoulders, unless we absolutely have to, take those hands out in front of those shoulders, and hold a nice long plank today, all right? So just like Manny's doing right there, long extended plank, so it'll be a little bit harder, force you to drive through your hands a little bit more, and force you to use that core 110% today, all right? 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off.
Feels so fun.
There we go, we got our time on. 40, 20, 5 rounds. So we'll get 5 minutes here to finish off this workout. Lock in, load up. Let's roll.
Let's do it, Green.
10 seconds. Woo! That's gonna be fun, I'm back.
2 and 1. Grab those toes into the ground.
Make sure we're not piking up either. We want good even hips to shoulder, all right? Flat back, tabletop position. Five, four, three, two, one.
Were your hands slipping?
My hands were slipping.
I'm like sliding forward. I'm like, oh no, this is not good.
That's happening to you too at home. If you're sliding out, try to push your hands in the ground, dig your toes in the floor. Use some of those muscles to push yourself down and lock in here. Also, wipe your hands off, maybe a little sweaty.
Oh, here we go.
Back into it, 40 seconds. Four, three, two, one.
I'm getting a pool of sweat.
I feel it all through my rib cage right here. That serratus pushing into the ground. Those little big muscles around that rib. I feel it. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. We got 10 more. Five, four, three, two, one.
Ooh.
Ooh. See in my shoulders. Double unders might be a mistake.
It jolts at first sight. I'm just like, I'm imagining me just face planning.
Just wanted to give out right there.
Three.
Right back into it. Second to last round here. Ten more. Four, three, two, one.
Woo!
Oh man. Last round.
Ooh.
I'm gonna hug myself right now. Woo. All that underside of the arm.
Oh. Alright guys, last one.
shirt after this one. You did it wrong. You should be drenched right now.
Oh, yeah. Right.
God, my lats. Almost at my lats.
From that. Yeah.
Dang. All right, guys. Out of way to finish all the way through. Warm up to finisher. Great job. We'll get you guys stretched out right here. Gonna drop down into a child's pose.
Yes.
Gonna get those arms stretched out here. Kind of tilt those shoulders into the ground, left to right, left to right. Good, bring onto our stomachs here. Gonna go into a press up. A little bit of that core. Try and draw that chin to the sky. Good, slowly bring it back down. Come up. Gonna take that right leg through our arms. I'm gonna go down into a pigeon pose. So we don't want that ankle directly lined back up with our thigh. We also don't want a 90-degree angle, somewhere in between a little happy medium. And if your right leg is through your hole, you take that right hand, drive into the ground, get a nice tall posture, and fall forward. Don't round out here, just keep it nice and tall. Lean that chest forward like you're a tree falling to the ground. Switch it up. Same thing on the opposite leg here. Good, use the opposite hand now. Support yourself, get nice and tall, and fall forward. Back down. Bring those feet together. Gonna go into a butterfly position here. You'll either use your elbows to drive your knees down or grab both your toes and try to actively press your knees into the floor here. And lower to the ground on their own.
I think the hardest was getting that jumper in the E2 mom. Just bust through it.
I couldn't get through. Three reps of double unders. Every time I started, it was like 1, 2, 3, mess up. 1, 2, 3, mess up. Now I get down. It's like the third rep was my worst enemy.
Just can't do that third rep.
Exactly. And once you get tired, double, you start thinking about it, start messing up. Like, what was I doing before?
What changed?
There we go. All right, lay it on back to our backs here. Point one heel to the sky. Grab behind that knee, then point your toes in with your face. Try to stretch that hamstring out here. great time with family and friends, and hope he finds some fireworks.
Yeah. And maybe that 10% rule. Good. Have a little bit of that. Enjoy some good food.
4th of July honor roll meal, maybe.
Yeah.
But until then, let's get a creed on three. One, two, three.
Green. Bye,
guys. Enjoy having y'all.